Hi, welcome to my desk. My name is Ashley, and we have a new hour of work to do. I'm so glad you're here. Congratulations, you woke up, you showed up. I love to see it. You're prepared to work with me for 1 hour in real time using our beloved, our cherished Pomodoro technique, which means we'll do 2 25-minute work sections. That's where we listen to white noise and we focus on the task at hand. What counts as a task? Literally anything you want, okay? You're doing your homework. You're writing a novel. You want to list out your enemies in alphabetical order. If you brought it to the desk today, it counts. We'll have 1 5-minute break right in the middle where you can get up and stretch, maybe refill your beverages, maybe book yourself a pedicure. Hey, it is sandal season. If you want a little human interaction, I will be here during the break talking about a certain subject as always. And then after that, we'll do our second 25-minute work section. And then after that, we can close our computer, go out into the world, feel good, knowing we already showed up, we already sat down, we already took care of business. How's that sound? Great. So today I'm drinking an iced coffee and an ice water. I'm going to be working on a short story. I would love to know what you're going to work on and what beverages you have. Wonderful. Well, let's get comfortable. Let's get everything exactly where we want it. And I'll count us in for this first work section. The first 25 minutes flies by. You will be shocked. Are you ready? Great. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. Ding, 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 friends. Woo! 25 minutes? More like 25 seconds. Am I right? I'm putting 5 minutes on the clock. Get up, do a little stretchy stretch. You know, I haven't said this in a while, but don't forget you have a body. Ooh. Oh, that feels good. I started going to a chiropractor. Did I tell you guys about this? You know that I think I mentioned my shoulder. I hurt my shoulder because I talked about the Roger/Peter fiasco where I was going to a masseuse and calling him Roger, but his name was Peter. Classic. And then a couple weekends ago, Peter told me, by the way, he was like, you should get this looked at because my shoulder was getting better, but not a lot better. So then over a weekend, 3 weeks ago, someone recommended a chiropractor to me. So I went and I saw her. I'm seeing her, I should say. It's happening. I bought a package of appointments. I always get the package, okay? If you tell me it's $50 a session or $48 if I buy 10, I'm buying the package. I don't know why my brain overrides common sense, but I'm going to see her and she's helping my shoulder a lot. Mainly she has this machine that she like hooks up and it zaps my shoulder with electricity and it is incredible. I'm like, how can I get my hand on this machine? But she also gave me some like exercises to do. I'm like, what is this? Exercises to do. I've been doing them. So it's making a difference, but she did throw out my lower back. Did I already talk about this on the channel? I apologize if I did, but she was like, we're going to do something to your lower back. It's all connected, you know? And I was like, okay. And so I went on this table. It kind of went like this while I was on it, but like really more on the lower back side of things. And, I was like, that felt weird. And then could not move my lower back for like a week. And I went and saw her and I was like, my back's like completely out. Like I can't tie my shoes. I can't bend down. She was like, yeah, the traction machine. When we did that to your lower back, she's like 5% of people that happens to. The other 95 benefit it from it. And I was like, 5%. You should have warned me. So then it was out for like a couple of weeks and I did lots of heating pads, but that's not the point of today's break. I actually have a point today. I have a point. Have I talked too much? No. Okay. So, you know, we've been going over all these tips about like how to get like how to stop worrying about what other people think about you. And I told you that when I was Googling that and researching that topic, something that kept popping up was like, how to stop being a people pleaser? Are you a people pleaser? Like, break your habit of people pleasing. And I was like, that's interesting. I never really thought of those two things as being connected. And then I was like, am I a people pleaser? I might be. I did Gretchen Rubin's 4 Tendencies and I was an obliger. Any obligers out there? So I looked into people pleasing. We're going to talk about it because I think I might be. I'm embarrassed. To be honest, I never thought if you asked me 2 weeks ago, Ashley, are you a people pleaser? I'd be like, I'm an Ashley pleaser. That would have been my answer. But then after looking through all these articles, I have to admit what I see staring back in my face, staring straight in my face, staring back at me. You get it, is that I'm a people pleaser. Okay, here are our tips on how to stop being a people pleaser. Number one, realize you have a choice. People pleasers often feel like they have to say yes when someone asks for their help. Remember that you always have a choice to say no. That's big. I did, and I will probably continue to do so many podcasts that I just say yes to. And then I'm like, wait, what's this podcast? Because someone asked me to do it. I'm like, I'm not even an expert on Marvel comics. They're like, talk about what you know. That's never happened, but that's like an idea. You get it. Number two, set your priorities. Knowing your priorities and values helps you put the brakes on people pleasing. This popped up a lot with the how to get over worrying that people are talking about you. It's like, set your priorities, set your values, think of the bigger picture. Knowing your priorities and values helps you put the brakes on people pleasing. You know, when you feel comfortable saying no or saying yes, ask yourself, what are the most important things to me? 3. I love this one. Stall. That's right. Whenever someone asks you for a favor, it's perfectly okay to say that you'll need time to think about it. This gives you the opportunity to consider if you can commit to helping them. Time's up. I never remember that I can stall. And just recently, I've started stalling on things. And guess what? I love it. It's wonderful. You don't have to reply to an email within 24 hours. You simply don't. 2 days would be good, maybe 3 days, but not right away. You don't have to do it. I'm going to keep working on what I'm working on. What are you going to work on? Great. Okay, I'm going to count us in. Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Thank you.
Ding, 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 friends. We just did an hour. It feels so good. We're done with our second 25-minute work section. You know what that means. You can go live your lives. And it's a Friday, my favorite day of the week. Go out there, enjoy yourself. Thank you for working with me. I'll see you on Monday at 10 a.m. Bye.